Physics we will continue. In the previous class we stopped with angular velocity and angular acceleration. Okay, angular term we will use for rotational motion. If it is ordinary motion we will use linear velocity, linear acceleration. If it is in rotational motion we will use the term angular velocity and angular acceleration. Okay, similarly if you apply force in a linear distance, in a linear way means what? Pushing or pulling. Okay, if you apply force normally we will call it as force. If the force causes rotational motion, you are applying a force, and if that force is causing rotational motion we will call it as torque. What do we call? Torque. So torque means it is a force which causes rotation about a fixed point. Which causes rotation about a fixed point. So that is called as torque. So if I take this book, okay, now I am holding the book here and I am going to apply force in the upward direction. So if I apply force in the upward direction, what is happening? The page is moving in a rotational motion. Yes or no? So this is the axis. The page is rotating about this axis. So we will call this as torque. We will not call this as force. We will call this as torque. So the force which I am applying, it is making the page to move in a rotational way. Okay, that is called as torque. Similarly, when you open and close a door. Okay, so when you pull the door or when you push the door, what is happening? That force is causing rotational motion. So that is called as torque. So torque means the force which causes rotation. Okay. So the amount of torque depends upon the distance from the fixed point. Now for example, this book is there. Okay, here this is the fixed point. Okay, if I apply force, the rotation will occur along this fixed point. Okay, so if the distance from the fixed point is more, I should apply more force to open this book. Suppose if the page is little bit longer, then I will be applying more force. Okay, so if the distance from the fixed position is more, the torque also will be more. If the distance from the fixed position is less, then torque also will be less. Okay. So, if the distance is more, torque is also more. That is directly proportional. Okay. So, now I am considering x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. The symbol for torque is tau. The symbol for torque is tau. It is a vector quantity. Vector quantity means what? It has both magnitude and direction. So I am taking the point O. From the point O, I am considering a point P. So the distance between O and P is R vector. Okay. So the distance between O and the point P is R vector. So I am slightly extending this R vector. Okay. Now I am going to apply force on this point P in this direction. I am going to apply force in this direction. So, the angle between the R vector the distance vector and the force vector, I am going to consider it as theta. So like this, I will. This I am considering it as theta. Okay. Now I am extending this force vector like this. Okay, the force vector I am extending like this. Okay, and I am going to draw a perpendicular from O to this force vector. So perpendicular means this angle will be 90 degrees. So what is this distance called as? This distance is called as a perpendicular distance. So perpendicular distance is r sin theta. R sin theta. Okay. So I am applying a force F on the point P. The point P is at the distance r vector from the origin. So when I apply this force, what is happening? The point P is going to undergo a rotational motion. So this force is called as what? It is a torque, because it is causing what motion? Rotational motion. So this torque will be perpendicular to both this F vector and R vector. That is what we studied in your second lesson physics. Okay. In second lesson physics, if you take two vectors, A vector and B vector, the resultant of these two vectors will be perpendicular to both the vectors. So F vector is there, R vector is there. The resultant of these two vectors will be perpendicular to both F vector and it will be perpendicular to R vector also. So that torque will be is in this direction. Okay, so this is just a graphical representation for torque. So torque is equal to F force into perpendicular distance r sin theta. What is AB sin theta? A vector dot B vector is AB cos theta. In second lesson we studied A vector dot B vector is AB cos theta. Then what is AB sin theta? A vector cross B vector. Cross product means it is sin theta. Dot product means it is cos theta. So here it is sin theta. So we can write it as cross product. F vector cross R vector. So this is the expression for tau. So tau is also called as the moment of force. It is also called as the moment of force. So if they ask the definition for torque, you can write the force which causes rotation, or you can write torque is defined as the moment of force. The next one is angular momentum. Linear momentum you studied. Yes or no? What is linear momentum? In Newton's law of motion lesson you studied. P is equal to mv. You studied. Yes or no? Total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. That and all you studied. So that collision is in linear way. So linear momentum means if it is moving in a straight line like that, means we will tell it as linear momentum. So if the body is moving in a circular way, we will call that as angular momentum. Angular momentum, the symbol is L. This is also a vector quantity. So angular, the term we will use when the motion is a rotational motion. So angular momentum means it is the rotational analog. Rotational analog of momentum. Rotational analog of momentum means momentum which represents the rotational motion. Momentum which represents the rotational motion. here force is there, yes or no? What is torque? Torque is also force only, but that force is in, that force will cause rotational motion. So normal force, if you cross product it with distance, you will get the value for the rotational motion. Same way, the normal momentum, if you do the cross product with the distance, you will get for the rotational motion. Okay, so L vector is equal to P vector cross R vector. So here we will call it as moment of force, here we will call it as moment of linear momentum. Moment of linear momentum. Next one is relation between torque and angular momentum. Relation between torque and angular momentum for single particle system. For a single particle system. Single particle means what? Only one particle is there. I am going to consider a body which is having only one particle. Okay. So what is the formula for tau? Tau is equal to F vector cross R vector. What is the formula for L vector? P vector cross R vector. Okay. Now this I am going to take it as equation number 1. This I am going to take it as equation number 2. I am going to differentiate 2 with respect to time. I am going to differentiate 2 with respect to time. That means I am going to multiply both the sides by d by dt. I am going to multiply both the sides by d by dt. So what I will get? dl vector divided by dt is equal to d by dt into p vector cross r vector. What is the differentiation of uv? U into v. What is the differentiation formula? U into v. Differentiation you studied in max, right? Still the topic didn't come. So differentiation of uv, if you multiply two products and if you take the differentiation of the multiplication, what will be the formula? Differentiation of uv, u into v will be u into differentiation of v by dt plus v into differentiation of u by dt. First you should write u term as it is, you have to differentiate only v term, plus v term write as it is, then differentiate only u term. Now how will you write here? dl vector by dt is equal to, first I should write the p term as it is and I should differentiate only r term. So p vector cross dr vector divided by dt plus r term as it is cross dp vector divided by dt. Understood? Now dl vector, so this I will keep it as equation number 3. Now you take this term dr divided by dt into p vector. This term alone I am taking. P cross dr vector divided by dt. What is the formula for p vector? What is the formula for p? Already in Newton's lesson we studied. P is equal to mv. So p vector I can write it as m into v vector. Mass is a constant, it will not change, but velocity is a vector quantity. So p I am writing it as m into v vector. What is r? R is the distance. Change in distance with respect to time, that is called as velocity. Change in displacement with respect to time is called as velocity. So this will also become B vector. Okay. So when you cross two same vectors, in yesterday's class I told you, when you cross two same vectors, the product will be equal to 0. So it will become m into 0. So this will become 0. So this term, which is in equation number 3, this term will become 0. Okay. Two vectors, what is the cross product? Cross product means what? AB sin theta. We are taking the cross product of same vectors. Same vectors will not have any angle between them. So sin 0 will become 0. That is why if you cross two same vectors, the answer will be equal to 0. In yesterday's class I told you. Okay. So now what will happen? This term will become 0. So remaining what I will be getting here? Tell me. DL vector divided by dt is equal to, this will become 0. So you will be getting only r cross dp divided by dt. What is dp vector divided by dt? This already in Newton's lesson you have studied, laws of motion lesson. Dp vector divided by dt is equal to force. Change in momentum with respect to time is equal to force. So substitute that here, what I will get? DL vector divided by dt is equal to r vector cross f vector. What is r vector cross f vector? What is r cross f? It is tau. So DL vector divided by dt is equal to tau vector. This is the relation between tau and L for a system of single particle. Okay, for a system of single particle. Suppose if the system contains many particles. Okay, so if the system contains many particles, what will be the thing? Many particles means the body will be present, many particles will be present. N number of particles will be present. Yes or no? So I will be applying a force for this body. That force will cause this body to move in a rotational way. Yes or no? So the force which I am applying, it will make the body to move in a rotation. So that means what? That force is called as torque. So the torque which I am applying to move the body in a rotational way, that torque is called as the external torque. That will be equal to F into R. Okay. But there are many particles here. Yes or no? Body vandu will be having many particles. Will the particles be as it is? It will be keeping on moving. Yes or no? So the particles themselves, they will be moving continuously inside the body. So what will happen? One particle will be exerting a force on another particle in equal and opposite direction. So all the particles will be, what they will be doing? They will be exerting a force on another particle in equal and opposite direction. So the internal torque will be equal to 0, because this particle's force and this particle's force, it is cancelling each other. So the torque which is present, already present in the body, will be equal to 0. So the torque will be only the torque which we are providing. Okay. So external torque, how we can calculate? For the first particle, for the second particle, for the third particle, for the fourth particle, up to, if there are n particles, like this we can calculate. So first particle means you have to write tau 1, L 1, like this. This is for only one particle. So like this, for tau 1, tau 2, tau 3. Okay, so like this. So this will be the torque for the system of particles. The last topic for today, conservation of angular momentum. No, sir, I will teach. Aditya, you took leave, lad.
No, sir.
Conservation of angular momentum. How angular momentum and torque are related? Tau vector is equal to dl vector divided by dt. Suppose if tau is equal to 0, if tau is equal to 0, then dl vector divided by dt is also equal to 0. What is dl vector divided by dt? L vector means what? Angular momentum. dl divided by dt means change in angular momentum with respect to time. That is 0. That is 0 means what? Angular momentum is not changing with respect to time. That is the meaning. Okay. So, if torque is 0, the change in angular momentum is also 0. Change in angular momentum is also 0. So what is the meaning of this? If change in angular momentum is 0 means, that means the angular momentum is not at all changing. So angular momentum does not change. Angular momentum does not change. So angular momentum is not changing means angular momentum is conserved. So this is called as conservation of angular momentum. So angular momentum is conserved. Okay, so this is called as conservation of angular momentum. So the next topic will be equilibrium of a body, that we will continue in the next class.